Our next presenter is Professor Chris Bandiapate from the Department of Natural Sciences. Chris is a professor of chemistry, and he's going to talk to you about nanoparticle as catalyst, cancer remediation, and biosensor. Chris.
So you're going to tell me, like, when to start.
Ready?
Okay. All right. Good morning. It's great to be here. You will see slides are a little busy, but I will direct you towards, you know, whatever we need to focus. So I put that three project I was trying to do, it's a bit ambitious, nanoparticle assembly, biosensor, and core shell nanoparticle. So we're going to see what are the things. So the unified part here is nanoparticle. So we are going to see what is actually nano all about. So nano is a 1 billionth, it's a 1 billionth of a meter, it's a human hair, you can see 5,000 nanometer across, smallest things we can visible is 10,000 nanometer across. And the nanoscience is basically the study of anything in between 1 to 100 nanometer. And the application of nano structures are called nanotechnology. So, and then what happened, once you go in that small regime, the material started behaving in different way. Sometimes it is actually, there are a number of opportunities in that regime, and so you can have unique electrical, optical, magnetic, and other properties, and there are also less analyte, you need more reaction site, so you can generate highly sensitive devices out of this. All right, so, and then this is also a science which is actually an interdisciplinary. It has been, you know, brought from different discipline, chemistry, ranging from chemistry, material science, engineering, physics, and so on. Now, when you see these nanoparticles generated, mostly it is in pre-synthesized in solution, but that is not going to see the potential impact. You have to organize this in a fashion that you can use as a device. Like, for example, that QLED that you see expensive from Samsung, those are like, you know, devices that are organized. So we need to organize in a one-dimensional, two-dimensional, or three-dimensional fashion. Our focus is going to be two-dimensional, and going forward, we are going to use those two-dimensional nanoparticle assemblies for catalysis, nanocatalyst. Then we are going to see generating things on a spherical surface for cancer remediation and heat absorber, and then we are going to look at the biosensor. So this is, like again, I said, busy slides. What we do here in terms of, so we take a surface, we functionalize with some positive charge layer with this molecule and hook up an ion and then change it, that ion, to that specific nanoparticle. So you can see here, we have generated, this is atomic force microscopy, things you can see in nanoscale. There are special microscope. I don't have time actually to explain, but you will see some of the microscope that we can see. It's a different from optical microscope, and you generate these gold nanoparticle, and you can see a surface becoming red in color. Here, it's a silver nanoparticle. And the catalyst is what we are going to use, this fuel cell, we call direct, alcohol fuel cell. These are generated to have alternate power source for handheld, you know, small devices. So this we are going to use as a catalyst, and you can see, we know that any battery has anode and cathode, right? So anode, we have this oxidation. So methanol, I just give you an example. Methanol is oxidized to CO2, and cathode, it's the oxygen is reduced to hydrogen, water. And this is the overall reaction. I just show you that one of the earlier Toshiba has this kind of fuel cell. So our goal is to come up with this oxidation reaction. We have also generated palladium nanoparticle, which can use for, you know, use for oxidation of longer chain alcohol, not just methanol, because sometimes methanol is toxic. Here you can see there's a, you know, like a nice diagram. What it actually tells you that it's these peaks are oxidation. So they are all active catalysts. The only thing which you have to identify, the forward current versus back, the reverse current. These values are going to tell you how good this catalyst is. So you can see these lower panel for ethylene glycol and glycerol, palladium is actually a very good catalyst. Okay, now the interesting part. This is the core shell structure. Now why I put these things here? M&M and chocolate coated pretzel. Now the question is, when you eat M&M, it's a crunchy and chocolate inside, right? It gives you a different flavor. Like for example, the chocolate coated, salty and chocolate. So we like it, right? It's a unique property. Same way, when you have something not conducting, with coated with something conducting, it gives you a great material properties. That's exactly what happened. See, SiO2 coated with gold, it's a dielectric and gold, and it actually absorbs, depending on the shell thickness, in the IR range. What is the reason? If you have those kind of material, it can actually absorb radiation from the IR range and gets heated up. And that can be used for destroying cancer cells. So we are, we have made this, again, following the same procedure what we have, I have shown you, that gold, you know, we absorb. This is not a flat surface, it's a sphere. And we generate, we put a polymer, and then absorb AuCl4, and then that smooth sphere become a hairy ball. And then the hairy ball gets closed, you have the whole surface is covered. Same way we can have the palladium shell. So here is the thing. This is another microscope called transmission electron microscope. We have it here. See here, this smooth becomes the hairy ball, and then it becomes a closed shell. And this is the absorption that we are talking about in the IR range. This is also, as you use the 808 laser, you can see that there is the change in the temperature. From 25 room temperature, the nano shell get into 40 degree in no time, like 10 minutes, and that has been used for 2 minutes?
No.
That has been used for the killing of the cancer cell. And I forgot to mention that we had an MQ project with Professor Kalan Kandapalli and Ben Lee from engineering, and we are also involved in doing this for quite a while. This is the palladium shell, palladium nanoparticle again. There's a palladium seed here. Seed means those hairy things, the little things. And then we can actually change the thickness of this, like how much chocolate you want. We can do that. Here is the thing, the last part is the bioelectronics. So when you have any analytes that you want to analyze, you have to put it in on a surface. And then the surface or whatever the device, whatever the interaction happen, you get an electronic signal. Resistance change, maybe current change, those things, right? So here we are going to sense dopamine. And why dopamine is important? Definitely these are the, one of the neurotransmitter. And these are the reason why you have to have that dopamine. It's a small molecule. So we are going to look at the change in current or potential. Here we generate same way, palladium nanoparticle. This is atomic force microscope. You see the size, mean size is around 7 nanometer. And this is where we do current versus potential plot. This is like a jargon, differential pulse voltammetry. This is one of the electrochemical techniques that we use. And what it happens, see, from 2.5 micromolar, means as the concentration is increasing, the dopamine concentration is increasing in solution, the current is increasing. So that way we can sense, we can actually go really, really down low, even nanomolar, not even micromolar. And also here, we can do it in presence of ascorbic acid, which is one of the component present in the human body, along with dopamine. So we need to see those interference. So I want to also recognize this part, my student. These are some of my earlier student. They have been, some of them have already graduated, like Amy, Alyssa. These are in the graduate school. This is one of the 2010 San Francisco ACS meeting. And now for the recent one, We have fall ACS meeting here, a group, and you know the fall 2018 ACS meeting. And also I have some of my students here also whose picture is not here. So they are the one who actually made these things happen. You know, I go, you know, I scribble things, I hand wave, then things happen, right? And also, Gabriela knows those because I keep sending the request for student travel. So she knows all of these students. And finally, without this, nothing can be happened. So I really thank the funding agencies for my supporting my research. And thank you all for your, you know, your attention.
Hold it. Good.